It's the Gilda Sue Rosenstern Computer Internet Show.
Hello, lovelies. I'm Gilda Sue Rosenstern. Thank you so much for joining us for this installment of a little something we love to call Gilda Sue's Game Reviews. Now, faithful viewers might remember that at the last installment, I was growing a tad weary of going down to the local singles club at the mall Game Girl. Just as a recap, it's a little place that on Wednesdays we girls get together and brush up on our gaming skills so that we're ready for Saturdays when we open the door to the local singles gaming men for mingling and competition and dating and hopefully relationships. But y'all, I was beginning to really and truly believe that this is not a place where a nice Jewish girl like me was ever going to meet a nice Jewish boy. But y'all, I also discovered that I'm really enjoying the gaming. Especially since they added this new game to the mix. It's called Capes and Cowls, Adventures in Weird City. Now y'all, I like this game so much, I brought this copy home to share with my nephew Evan. And as it turns out, this game is linked up with a whole series of comic books with these classic superhero characters in it that Evan has been following for years. So it makes sense now, I know why they call it a book in a box, because y'all, this is just like a bunch of little short stories, and you get set pieces, and you get these little game pieces, and you can act out the short stories and just beat each other bloody as you go. Now, y'all, it takes place in a little town called Weird City, and they spell that funny W-Y-R-D for whatever reason, and y'all, it is filled with fascinating characters. Y'all, they've got robot people and kitty people. They've got liberty-squelching Liberty Bots. They've got freedom-hating Freedom Patrol. They're all in here, all these characters. They've got Diablo Azul. Now, he's a stage magician gone wrong. They've got a misanthropic spider whisperer called the Brown Recluse. They've got Phantasm. That's Evan's favorite. Dr. Grim Fate. They've got the Golden Rocket. So as y'all can see, they've just got something for everybody. In every character, there's lots and lots of characters. And every single one has its own bio in this little book. And the bios are fascinating. They read very much like a free-form, deconstructed Spenserian sonnet. I will confess that my very favorite character of all, and this might be really why I love the book, I got a little crush, on the Nightshade. Now, he's a star Nightshade. Here's his little card. You can see all his special superpowers are listed here. Everybody's got special superpowers. Yo, the Nightshade, honest to goodness, I believe, is going to have to be this season's Gilda Sue Sexiest Superhero Alive. I mean, this man has got it going on. He has a black and purple suit made of night. I know. I mean, can you wrap your brain around that? Can y'all even begin to imagine what in the world kind of kisser a man with a black and purple suit made of night might be? I know I can. Y'all, let me get back to the point about the game, though. I did some research on the game, and I discovered that the game and the comic books are all written by the same author who wrote a book that we recently featured on Used Book Club, Wondrous Strange. Now, what kind of a coincidence is that? That, I believe, is what they call synchronicity. His name is Robin Spriggs, and here he's popping up again in one of my favorite new games. Anyway, y'all, I really recommend that you get the game and that you play it. It's super good. I give it 13 Canisius, 9 Lotkas, and 3 Blintzes. Thanks so much for joining us. Y'all join us next time. And remember, all work and no play makes Jebediah a schnook. Bye now.
Buff, buff.